Hi, I'm Pastor Mark from the Bangor First Church of the Nazarene. I'm in a series right now on forgiveness, and today we're looking at Matthew 6, verse 12. And this is smack dab in the middle of the Lord's prayer, and you're familiar with it. I'm pretty sure you will be familiar with it, maybe a different version. And it says this, "And forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors." Let's pray. Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that your Holy Spirit would teach us, that you would send your Spirit, and that he would remind us and guide us and empower us to understand this. I ask in this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, lately, I've encountered a number of people that are just straight out with me, honest, and say, I have no interest in forgiving so-and-so. And there's reasons for this, and we're going to explore some of those reasons. It's dangerous, if you will, this particular bit about unforgiveness. But I'm in the middle of a devotional, and I can't be exhaustive here. This isn't going to be a doctoral dissertation. It is a devotional, and so we're going to hit on some things, and I'm trusting that you and the Holy Spirit will work out anything that is new to you and will guide you, and of course, you can always reach out and give me a jingle if you want to discuss this further. But this particular bit, this forgive us our debts. The next two words are just, they're presumptuous. As we also have forgiven our debtors. Forgive us as we. It's presumptive. It's this kind of latent potential behind the statement, as we. And in other words, we are forgiving, we're forgiven as we are forgiving. There's this snowballing. It's like, I'm trying to find my place down here. It's like we're gracious and grateful as we're being gracious and grateful. You know, you meet these people, and like you meet them in a store, and they'll say, "Oh, excuse me, oh, I didn't mean," and they're just oozing graciousness, and it inspires you to be gracious, and you know, to other people, it just creates this effect, and it is it's not only that, it gets passed around from mature individual to other mature individuals. Or developing maturity, if you will, maturing individuals, healing individuals are absorb this type of character, so that like somebody that is typically is not a grateful person, an ungrateful person, when they see and they're around others who are just patently grateful, you've met them, they're like, "Oh, thank you," and they're genuine. They just, "Oh, they're so thankful for this, they're thankful for that," and eventually the ungrateful person gets pulled into that. It's this gracious vacuum, if you will, and This is the way we are. As Christians, we do this, and forgive us our debts as we are forgiving others, and that's what we're doing. It's in our Christian DNA, and this is what Jesus is laying out as a standard, and it's interesting, if you read on to verse 14 and 15, there's a gotcha on that. We've talked about that in past discussions and past videos. You could probably look back and find that. Now, there's some hindrances to this and into this process of as we. Forgive us our debts as we. You see, In our as we go through life, we're going to meet people that are not going to be involved in the economy of God the way we are. You know, the economy of God says that we are as we are forgiving, that we are inherently growing and maturing and developing and forgiving others as we are seeking forgiveness ourselves. But you see, the other person, and I'm sorry, it may be you, it may be me at times, we're not doing the as we ask for forgiveness, but we aren't forgiving. And that may be because the other person is an unbeliever. Maybe you're an unbeliever. Maybe you're not a person who has received and believe and have given your life to Christ and asked Him to forgive you ask Him to forgive you of your sins. And if you're not, just hang with me, because health and healing are in the wings. It's there for us. But we need to receive and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, ask for forgiveness. And for those that haven't, they've never received the Holy Spirit. And it is the Holy Spirit in us that gives us this resurrection power and this ability to forgive others and to be forgiving and gracious and grateful and all of that, the characteristics of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, if the other person isn't, then they're devoid of the Holy Spirit, and they are lacking the categorical blessings and power of God. And when you are in a skirmish or a tangle, however, where there needs to be forgiveness, if the other person is not a believer, doesn't have the Holy Spirit, there is a mismatch. There's a mismatch of expectations and desires. For example, the other person may not give a rip about forgiving others. This is what recently, I've run into people that they don't care. The apathy is to the point where they don't care about the other person, whether there's forgiveness or not. And they're just as happy to live a life of bitterness and unforgiveness. It doesn't affect them. And can you imagine this rising up in marriage, where perhaps one is a believer and one is not? It's like driving a bicycle with a flat front tire, where the back tire is the believer, the front tire is an unbeliever, and I mean there's motion, but there's no stability. And a marriage like that, or a relationship like that, whether it's at work or at the grocery store, that mismatch is unhealthy. And you can't go to God and say, "Forgive us our debts as we've forgiven our," with a person that has no interest in forgiveness. And so there's that's around us. And we as believers, those who are us disciples who are learning, we need to understand that sometimes when we're involved in forgiveness, the other person may not be involved, have no commitment, no desire. And so our approach needs to be above that. Now, let's say the other person is a new believer. Then that goes along with this video series. We are all disciples. We are all learning. And a strong believer who's involved with a new believer and there's an offense, well, then this is an opportunity for discipleship, not anxiety. Grace and love would empower the mature believer to come alongside and love and develop and in love, disciple the other person. And so this is a call for us to have grace in prayer. If I ever have an entanglement with another believer where there's been a misunderstanding or anger or whatever, I go to God and I ask for wisdom and I ask for grace on the other person, because there is a love triangle in the family of God where God's grace is flowing to that other person as much as it is to you. And it's incumbent on us for that grace to flow from us to that other person. And so the new believer, we need to approach in love and humility, never in pride and never in I'm better than you. Arrogance never wins, we'll just leave it at that. Time's getting on here. The new believer needs to understand that verse 14 and 15 of Matthew exist, where Jesus gives a commentary on the verse we're looking at, verse 12. He gives a commentary and he says, look, if you forgive, you're going to be forgiven. If you don't forgive, you will not be forgiven. He meant that. He said it. And that's the way it is. And so when we encounter others, it is as we are involved with asking forgiveness and we are involved with giving forgiveness. Those are the characteristics of Jesus Christ: honesty, transparency, grace, prayer, love. These are the things that are in our DNA that empower forgiveness. And if you're not, if you're not forgiving and you say you're a believer, you've got problems. Your bicycle has a flat front tire. Your spiritual bicycle is wobbly. It's not sound. There's no stability if you are not forgiving. It says it in verse 6:12, and forgive us our debts as we have also. That's in the past. We have to have a history of forgiving. If we don't, then we need to get before God and ask for forgiveness for an unforgiving spirit. It leads to bitterness. It leads to poor relationships, certainly a bad marriage and bad relationships. So my encouragement to you is be a forgiving person. Seek out to God. Seek God for that if you're lacking. Let's pray. Father, we need you. We need your Holy Spirit to guide us, to teach us. Lord, we thank you for your teaching on forgiveness. And Lord, may you empower us to be forgiving others as we seek for forgiveness. Brother, sister, I pray that you receive this message and go out and are a forgiving person. God bless you.